Welcome to our session on study abroad for subject areas of engineering and computer science. We will cover program options in many regions of the world. We have a lot of information packed into this 15-minute presentation, so we'll move quickly. Please feel free to take screenshots of any of the slides. The presentation will also be available on the UCEAP website afterwards.
Let's start by highlighting the benefits of studying abroad through UCEAP. UCEAP is the official study abroad provider for the entire UC system. Our programs are designed specifically for UC students. With programs in over 40 countries, UCEAP has the perfect study abroad program to suit your needs. While on UCEAP, you remain enrolled in your UC campus, which means you do not need to take a leave of absence during your study abroad program, and your UC financial aid goes with you. As a UCEAP student, you're guaranteed that all the courses you take abroad will receive UC credit.
If you are looking for some experience in hands-on, high-level research, we have several options for you in Asia. To start, you can apply for the Engineering and Science program at Tohoku University in Japan. Tohoku University is known for developing innovations and hands-on learning. Guided by a faculty supervisor, work in a lab with international and Japanese students. Stay in Sendai for a full year and experience cherry blossoms in spring and snow in winter. Another option in Japan is the STEM Research in Osaka program. This program offers fall or spring programs as well as an 8-week summer option. If you do not have a full term to commit to study abroad, this might be a great fit. UCEAP offers another summer research program at the National Taiwan University in Taipei. Taiwan is well known for their technological advances. You can go for the summer and gain 8 weeks of research experience with renowned researchers. National Taiwan University, NTU, is a leading research center and Taiwan's top university. You will work in ultra-modern labs with local faculty, complete a research project, and get experience that you can take anywhere after graduation. Areas of research include biotechnology, computer science, and engineering. You can also attend NTU for the fall, spring, or year for classroom learning. For a classroom experience that combines a cultural experience in a historical setting, you might consider Tsinghua University in Beijing, China. You can see the Forbidden City or the Great Wall. Tsinghua University dominates world rankings in engineering, technology, and research. You could be part of innovative solutions to real-world problems at a campus built around ancient imperial gardens. Coursework in engineering is taught in English. Coursework taught in Chinese are offered in a wide variety of areas. If you're hoping for a more modern and exciting locale, you should consider the Hong Kong University of Science and Technology for fall or year. Ranked 12th in the world for global employability, this young university is creating a bright future for students. Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, HKUST, is an international research university with strong ties to partners in mainland China. Overlooking Clearwater Bay, the futuristic-looking Hong Kong University of Science and Technology campus is just 45 minutes from downtown. If you hope to go down under, you can study engineering and computer science in Australia at the University of Sydney. The University of Sydney is Australia's first university and one of the most highly regarded institutions in the world. Computer science courses include artificial intelligence, human-computer interaction, computer languages, and algorithm design. Internships with engineering firms are possible and offer real-world experience. Close to Australia is New Zealand, where we are currently developing a new program with the University of Canterbury. The University of Canterbury is New Zealand's second oldest university. This nearly 150-year-old university is in Elam, a suburb of Christchurch on the South Island. University of Canterbury's information and computer science faculty are among the top researchers in many areas, as you can see here, including cybersecurity. Another new program for engineers in Singapore is at the Singapore University of Technology and Design. SUTD is a technology and design focused university. Engineering majors will benefit from the program with an interdisciplinary approach incorporating elements of entrepreneurship, management, and design thinking. You will have full access to the Fab Lab Makerspace and its world-class arsenal of 3D printers, CNC machines, water jets, and much, much more.
Engineering and Computer Science in the Americas and Spain. You can study both computer science and engineering at the UNAM in Mexico City. Fall and spring semesters are both available, and those who are unsure of the year option can always extend from one semester to the next. Juniors and seniors with a minimum GPA of 2.85 are welcome. Because all classes are taught in Spanish, an intermediate language level is required. The fall program begins with group activities and trips, as well as an intensive language program, or ILP, during 5 weeks in the summer to prepare you for classes at the UNAM. Because there is no ILP for the spring program, we recommend that students take a Spanish language class before departure. The faculties and departments for both of these fields are located at the main campus, which means you are within easy distance of Coyoacán and Chimalistac, walkable bohemian towns with museums, art galleries, and colorful artisan markets. Mexico City may be a bustling metropolis, but students often find that before long, they've discovered a comfortable, relaxed pace all their own. Moving further down the Americas, the Pontifical Catholic University of Rio de Janeiro is another location for computer science and engineering students. What we call fall and spring semesters are reverse seasons in Brazil. If you opt to go from August to December, you'll experience the start of the rainy spring months into early summer. If you go from February to July, you'll be in Rio around the time of Carnaval and early winter. Juniors, seniors, and graduate students with a minimum GPA of 2.85 may apply. There are language prerequisites which can be satisfied with either university-level Portuguese or Spanish. A few engineering courses may occasionally be available in English, but for the most part, classes will be taught in Portuguese. To prepare you for Brazilian lectures, each semester begins with a 4-week intensive language course. Language study then continues during the term. Brazilian students work hard, but they take life in Rio just as seriously. With access to beaches, mountains, amazing food, and a thriving arts, music, and museum scene, there is no shortage of what this program offers. Crossing the Atlantic, we have Carlos III University of Madrid, well known for its internationalization efforts. In fact, many of the degrees it offers come in bilingual modalities, that is, courses available in Spanish and English, especially those in the STEM fields. The program is open to juniors and seniors with a minimum 2.75 GPA. There are no prerequisite courses or majors for application, but students are expected to have adequate preparation for any courses they opt to take. There is also no language prerequisite for the program. It is possible to take all your courses in English, though Spanish language study is required unless you place out. Course information can be readily found on the C3 website using the links on our program pages. If you are looking for courses to take during a specific term, pay attention to the semester 1 and 2 labels that correspond to UC Fall and Spring. You'll make all housing arrangements before arrival with resources provided by the study center and can choose between an apartment, dorm, or homestay. Though it may sound a bit daunting, finding your own housing and getting to know your Madrid neighborhood is all part of the study abroad experience. The last program we want to highlight in Spain is new and offers an opportunity for non-computer science or computer engineering majors to learn the foundations of data science and programming. While it may not be a traditional language learning option, acquiring a programming language is a useful skill to have. Beyond IT and software, Python is applied across other industries, from insurance and banking to business and healthcare. Students meet for lecture and labs from Monday to Thursday and work on a group project in collaboration with a local startup. Although the schedule is rigorous, there will be time for you to explore all Madrid has to offer. The program is open to sophomores, juniors, and seniors with a 2.5 minimum GPA. All majors are welcome and there are no language prerequisites as both classes are taught in English. Housing is prearranged in double occupancy dorms that are about a 20-minute walk to your classes at the UC Center Madrid.
There are many universities across Europe that have strong programs in the engineering and computer science fields, more than I could cover in this short presentation. Today I'm going to briefly highlight some of our strongest programs for these fields. But before I dive in, I want to touch on some of the benefits and commonalities of our programs in Europe. Firstly, these are all immersion programs, which means you'll be taking regular classes alongside local students and international students. You'll be able to explore the culture of your host country and city while taking coursework in your major. Additionally, most of these programs offer courses taught in English, so you won't need prior language study to participate. And finally, Europe is a hub for many global companies and brands, so it's a great place to pursue internship and research opportunities. Lund University in Sweden is a top choice for engineering majors in most disciplines. The university has a strong engineering department with a large amount of course offerings as well as research opportunities in English. There are also many courses that go beyond what might be available to you at your UC campus, including courses on hybrid vehicle design, product design, supply chain engineering, and more. Lund is a small town centered on university life, so it's a great option if you're looking for a community feel with lots of social activities to choose from. Technical University for Lund is a great destination for both engineering and computer science fields, with many exciting courses to choose from. Courses are offered in English and computer science and electrical engineering, while other engineering disciplines offer courses in German. You can take courses in German if you have at least 2 years of university-level German, or if you have 1 year of German and also enroll in the pre-intensive language program offered before the start of the term. This program is a great option if you're looking for a large European city experience at a university on the front edge of innovation. There are also opportunities to do internships in Berlin. The University of Copenhagen boasts a strong computer science department, with many advanced courses that are best suited for students who are in their third or fourth year of their computer science studies. This university combines traditional lectures and tutorials with project-based teaching methods, which develop strong problem-solving skills in your field. This program is great if you're looking for a metropolitan city experience and you're good at navigating your studies and your surroundings independently. Finally, I wanted to include a few additional programs in Europe that might fit your plans. These programs are all strong options, but just have some limitations or requirements that might not fit every student's plans. The University of Bordeaux is a small program beloved by the students that have attended. Engineering is a strong suit here, but keep in mind that courses are only offered in French. Uppsala University in Sweden has plenty of computer science offerings if you're looking to go abroad in the fall term, while University of Oslo in Norway is flipped. Its strong computer science offerings occur mostly in the spring semester.
In this section of the presentation, we'll highlight some really excellent opportunities to study STEM subjects, specifically engineering and computer science in England, Scotland, and Ireland. As with some of the European programs just mentioned, the following programs are also known as immersion programs, meaning that you can choose courses in almost any department. Of course, engineering and computer science majors will probably want to focus on their major field of study. You will be incorporated into the general student body of the university in which you are placed and attend classes alongside local and international students, immersed in the academic culture of your host university as well as the rich local culture. These UCEAP programs, Scottish universities, Irish universities, and English universities, are open to UC juniors and seniors who meet the minimum GPA requirements, which range from 2.85 to 3.3, depending on the university of choice. As you would expect, classes are taught in English and no foreign language skills are required for admission. Now, let's take a quick look at the following video and explore some of the more compelling reasons to consider studying in the United Kingdom and Ireland.
We'll be right back.
We hope this presentation has provided you with a starting point on your study abroad journey, and we encourage you to explore the UCEAP website for detailed information about program options, finances, health and safety, and more. You should also visit your UC Campus Study Abroad Office website for information on application steps and deadlines. Each UC campus has their own application process and deadlines, so please be sure to get in touch with your Campus Study Abroad Office for more information. Once you have determined which program you are going to apply to, you can start an application by selecting the Apply Now button on the UCEAP website. A valid passport is required for all study abroad programs. Processing times for passports are delayed due to COVID, so if you need a passport or if you need to renew your passport, you should start that process immediately. Appointments for one-on-one advising sessions with UCEAP advisors will be available during the week of November 2nd through 6th. The link for bookings is on the slide, and I have entered it into the chat as well.